This is a Putt Putt boat motor number 2, the super giant boat motor. This is a piece of copper tubing, and on this end I've split it with a hacksaw, split it open, and the plan is to put some silicone rubber in here and then to put a couple screws right through here into those ears. And it's hard to see, isn't it? Put it into those ears and hold it in place, and the silicone will not act as glue, but it will act as a sealant. So anyway, then we snap the top back on it and go from there. This is the inside. The silicone hasn't quite set yet. And the outside, like that. So when the silicone is all the way dry, I will snap the lid on. Then I need to figure out a boat for it. And this is with a lid on it. And just for a size comparison. As he's trying to go, we took an old paint thinner can and cut it in half and folded the edges so it wouldn't be sharp and stuck it in there. It's really trying to go. Pretty impressive. She does like to take a break every now and again. Sucking air too. We need to weight the back end down more so that it doesn't suck in air. But it really uses up fuel. It requires a lot of heat. We took the weight out of the back so that the nozzle is right at water level, and it seems to work a lot better. I think one of the problems is the boiler is too big again, and the pipe is too big. It's sucking water into the boiler, and then it takes too long to re-cook it. So by getting the tube above the water level, it's not sucking in so much water, and it's not cooling down the boiler. So this really fits. yeah. Anyway. Ah, there she goes. That's the sound you want.